Okay, this is the new Fidelity control box. It has many features. It has a built-in LED touchscreen, so you can control everything through the control panel. It can sync up to 4 actuators and run them exactly at the same speed. You don't have to use 4 actuators, you can use 1, 2, 3, or 4 actuators of different types. Today we're gonna try the utility actuators, the new Super Duty actuators, and the P-Series actuators. We'll show you how it runs all of them. You can adjust the speed of them, you can adjust the extending speed and the retracting speed. You can adjust the limit switches so that it can start and stop at a certain position. You don't have to rely on the built-in limit switches in the actuator itself. So we're gonna run through all of those and show you how to wire up an actuator. It'll work with many different actuators, not just a Fidelity actuator. It does have to have actuators that have built-in feedback, such as Hall sensors or optical sensors, which these do. Some of these have optical sensors, some have Hall sensors. It relies on that feedback to be able to give it speed control and also adjust the limit switches and do the syncing. And it runs on 12 or 24 volts, so it's very versatile. You can wire in a separate switch, you can control it via a switch, or an Arduino system or another PLC system, you can wire that in, or you can just literally control everything through the screen on the control box as well. It's very simple to use, so let's get into it. Okay, so let's show you how this control box works. Now, in the back, you'll notice there's a QR code. If you scan the QR code, it'll bring up the instructions manual online for you, so that's simple. And now the control box comes with a bunch of these green connectors, which just plug in like this. 4 large ones for actuators, and then 2 smaller ones, one for power and one for an external switch. And so if we plug one in, we'll plug this one in. This is a power. You'll see it'll just power up like that, very easy. So left is positive, right is negative, and it'll take 12 to 24 volts. I brought there's a separate power line coming off here that goes to the switch, because I'm also gonna use a simple rocker switch. So it goes to the middle of a rocker switch, and then use these two that goes to the second smaller green terminal. Any of these will do, doesn't matter, and we'll plug that in too. And that gives us a switch control over the actuators as well as manual control. Now, if you wanted to plug this into an Arduino or a PLC or a Control 4, another home automation system, these are the two wires where you will plug it in, and it's just a simple reversing polarity signal that the controller takes. We'll plug in one actuator, and the one we'll use is a Fidelity utility actuator. And I've already gone ahead and pre-wired it up. And these are simple. The left 2 are the power, and then the right 3 or 4, depending on what type of actuator you're using, this is the feedback from the Hall sensor or optical sensor that's built in. Most optical and Hall sensors have a 3-wire configuration. Some have 4-wire, and the instructions are on the back of the QR code, and that'll tell you exactly how to wire them up. It's very simple. So let's go ahead and plug this in. Now it's ready to go. Now the first thing you must do is you want to set the time of the system. So it's system set time. So 11, 12, 32, we'll save that. That's fine. You can set the date. You can even adjust the backlight to make it brighter or dimmer. And there's even a buzzer, so every time you press a button, you can hear it buzz. And then you want to do a calibration. So you want to go to actuator set, and let's do a calibration, cal. And what you'll see is the actuator is just going to go through a calibration sequence. See, it's extending. And then it'll retract, and that's how it'll do its calibration.
If you were running multiple actuators, it would actually calibrate all of the actuators at the same time, and we'll do that shortly. Now it stops. Now it's going to retract. Great thing about these utility actuators is they're super quiet. As you can barely hear these. These are very quiet actuators, but still quite powerful. Now when it gets fully retracted, you'll hear it'll triple click. There we go. And the green light comes on. And that now tells you it is ready to run. And we'll run through some of the settings now. You can control it through the switch. And you can see the actuator there moving. I'll retract it. Now let's plug in two actuators and show you how we sync a couple of actuators. So first thing we need to do is to tell it we're going to use two actuators. So dip switch up to show it we're using two actuators. We have another utility actuator here. We'll go ahead and plug it in. Now we've got two. We've got an actuator set and then calibrate. See, now both of them are running. They'll both extend and then retract. And look, you'll notice, see, one is faster than the other. And that's because I'm actually using in this, I'm cheating, I'm using two different force actuators. One is I think a 240-pound force actuator, and the other one is a 110-pound force actuator. So naturally, the lower force actuators run faster. Like in this mode, they're actually faster. One is faster than the other, you can see that. But once they're calibrated, they run at exactly the same speed. Okay, now they're calibrated. It flashed a few times. Same speed, and if you notice in the control box, it's also showing the stroke. If you can see that, but see, it's showing exactly what the stroke is. And you'll notice they are perfectly in sync. I'll retract them. Watch them stop at exactly the same time. There we go. So that's a perfect example of two actuators that do not naturally run at the same speed, but after we've used the sync box, it syncs them absolutely perfectly.